When the precondition and postcondition are given by array diagrams, the invariant is usually a generalization of both of them. Here is the general guideline for creating that generalization. The segments in R appear in the same order in the generalization. The segments in Q also appear in the same order in the generalization. Here's an example. Generalizing the 2 is easy. We have placed a variable h in the diagram to help mark the boundary between the two segments. You often have to do that. There is another way to generalize Q and R. Stop the video and draw the other generalization. The answer appears at the end of the PDF script for this video. Here's a second example of a pre and post condition. To generalize these, we can start with the post condition and place the query segment from Q at the beginning. Note that the segments appear in the same order in R and in the invariant. Variable H appears in the same place in both the post condition and precondition. In order to use this invariant, we have to mark the boundary between the first two segments. We can put a variable J like this. We could also have placed J to the right of the line. As you gain experience developing the loops, you will learn which one may be slightly better. There are two other ways to generalize Q and R, depending on where the query segment is placed. Stop the video and draw those two ways. The answers appear at the end of the PDF script for this video. Our last example comes from a program in which B sub H contains some value x initially. The values in B sub H dot dot k are to be swapped around, and a value is to be stored in J to truthify the post condition. We don't concern ourselves with that. All we have to do here is generalize Q and R. To generalize, start with R. Notice that we don't need to put a segment with x in it because there is already one, and we decide to place the query segment at the end. We use fresh variable t to mark the boundary. Note that in all three of these diagrams, h and k give the beginning and end of the array. Variable j is used in the invariant as it is used in the post condition. There is another way to generalize, depending on where the query segment is placed. Draw that one.